Draft is used to taper or angle specific faces of your designs. So, going back to our video game remote controller design here, we might remember we actually used the translate tools and scaling tools to apply a draft angle to this design. So if I just jump to a front view, for example here, we can see that this is pretty much just an extrusion. However, we can see that it's being extruded at some angle here. And that would be an example of our draft angle. So draft is very useful in some specific industries and specific manufacturing methods. So for example, most plastics might be injection molded. And in order to generate an injection mold, we would have to remove that plastic component from the mold itself. And you'll need that draft angle there in order to remove the part safely from the mold. If there was no draft angle or an insufficient draft angle, we might scratch up the sides when trying to remove it from the mold or break the plastic part completely. Hence, this draft angle just allows for the part to slide out of the mold a little bit easier. And in a very similar manner, metal castings would also need to have a draft angle applied. So, let's take a look at how we can apply this draft angle. I'm going to start off with just the sketch for my controller here. And instead of just pushing or pulling with the arrows here, as we've done previously, I'm actually going to go into my tools, and right at the top I have an extrude option. So here I can tap to select the faces or sketches I'd like to extrude. So that will be that same sketch here, and tap next. And then whatever length I'd like to extrude, so the default is 25 here, I can change that to maybe 15 or so on, whatever extrusion length or kind of thickness I'd like here. So this is very similar to just extruding with my arrows. The important difference, however, is I also have the ability to add a draft angle. So if I add a draft angle here, let's say of 5 degrees, and now I should be able to see, especially if I jump to maybe a front view, that I have that slight draft angle applied of about 5 degrees or so there. Of course, I can add any draft angle I'd like. I'm going to do a fairly drastic draft angle, let's say 15 degrees, just so we can see it more noticeably. And now you can see that draft angle has increased to about 15 degrees. Once happy with that, I can just tap my done check. And now I can see I've done my extrusion, but I've also applied a draft angle to all of these exterior faces. In the next lesson, we'll learn how to use the shell tools.